again. The two boxers are coming into this one, but Otto Joseph, like you trust him in the first round, is coming again powerfully into this, but Rashid Aremu trying to bring another system into this one. But let us see how the whole thing is going to pounce out, because he's starting on a very shaky note, but this time around he wants to correct the wrong in the second round. Let us see how Otto Joseph will respond to this one as the punches are coming from the two boxers, so to say. Innocent, what is your view again about what you are seeing?
Yes, Tunji, interesting boxing, amateur boxing here at the Indoor Sports Hall of University of Lagos, Akoka. Of course, obviously you can see that Otto Joseph seems to be the strongest of the two boxers and the most experienced. Aremu is also trying to hold his own here in this bout, but of course, you can be rest assured that at the end of the day, Otto Joseph will eventually emerge victorious.
Well, as we see so far, Otto Joseph has been dominant in this one, but he's far beyond that, because they still have one more bout to go, after one more round to go after this round we are witnessing, and this round is not even over yet. But the way we are seeing it, Otto Joseph has regained, you know, strength and is dominant in this one. You can see Otto Joseph, as we are saying it, is just trying to destabilize Rashid Aremu. Rashid Aremu, I don't know, he's not even making use of his height. He's trying to hold Otto Joseph in one of his hand, but you know, the referee just called the attention into that to be able to make sure that there is sanity, there are rules and regulations that follow boxing, precisely, that follow boxing, and that's exactly what the ref is trying to do. I think the ref had to stop fight for a while to attend to Rashid Aremu because of some irregularities that is just happening. But we are resuming again, and the two boxers are coming against each other. You can see Rashid Aremu is coming, trying to come into this one, coming gradually into this one, but Otto Joseph is trying to observe very well, observe before he throws his punches, and you can see the way it's going. Rashid Aremu coming to this, but Rashid Aremu, can you say he's coming back?
Oh, Tunji, in fact, I would not be surprised if we have a knockout in this fight. Otto Joseph is coming strong on Rashid Aremu, though Rashid Aremu is trying to fight back, but obviously Otto Joseph stands at the moment as the strongest boxer among the both. That is the end of the second round. The two boxers have retired to their corners. The coaches are attending to them at the moment.
We are resuming again. This is the third round of the six bouts, 60 kg of the 35th edition of the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame monthly Saturday boxing show. You can say what you call it in the local parlance, initial gra-gra. You can see the way Rashid Aremu is trying to throw punch against Otto Joseph. You are still with me here, Innocent. What is the makeup of that? What can you say? What is your contribution to that, what you are seeing now?
Yes, Tunji, I would like to say that I'm a bit surprised with the way Rashid Aremu is trying to hold his own against Otto Joseph. I would have expected that by now we would have had a knockout in this bout, but of course it shows that the resilience of the boxer Rashid Aremu haven't held his own till this point. But you can see Otto Joseph fighting seriously to ensure that he knocks Rashid Aremu out. Rashid Aremu holding him tied there. The referee is giving Rashid Aremu a warning. He's fighting back now. The hostilities have resumed. Otto Joseph trying to get the better of Rashid Aremu. He goes close. Goes close, and boxes him to the corner. They are holding themselves now. I don't know what these swans are trying to do, turning boxing into wrestling. But of course, the referee have at this time come to their aid. Now hostilities have resumed. Otto Joseph going close again on Rashid Aremu at the blue corner, unleashing punches on him. That is Otto Joseph. Oh, look at that. They are holding themselves again. Tunji, take away from there.
Innocent, thank you very much. is something that is quite interesting here. You can see the way Aremu is holding on to Otto Jose. That is a signal of tiredness. He's so tired. And Otto Jose, a very resilient boxer, is taking no for an answer. He wants to knock him out quickly, even though it's the last round of this bout, but he wants to knock him out. He wants to ensure that it's a knockout. And that's why you could see, even Aremu cannot make use of his height. Aremu is tired, but Otto Joseph is taking no for an answer, wants to knock him out. And that's what we are seeing here. Best of amateur boxing. Quite interesting. The crowd are enjoying it. They enjoy it. They like it. They are getting themselves attuned with amateur boxing, courtesy of the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame. It's the 35th edition. Trying to revive amateur boxing again. And the bell goes again. And that's the end of everything. That's the end of the bout. We are waiting the judge's decision now. Yes, we are awaiting the judge's decision now. And by unanimous decision, as we have predicted, Otto Joseph won this one. Otto Joseph of Paramount Boxing Club won the sixth bout of the 60 kg of the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame monthly Saturday boxing show. Yasu, the vice chairman of the Lagos Amateur Boxing Association, is the one doing the presentation, and is doing the presentation now. He's giving the runner-up, and the champion, Otto Joseph, is about to receive his gift from Alhaji Ilyasu now. And Otto Joseph is receiving his gift now from Alhaji Ilyasu, Otto Joseph of the Paramount Boxing Club. The seventh bout of the 35th Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame monthly Saturday boxing show. This is the seventh bout inside the indoor sports hall of the Sports Center, University of Lagos. And we are about to witness the bout between Ahmed Rufai and Adedeji Adekunle of Diamond Boxing Club. And Ahmed Rufai of No Shaking Boxing Club is a 64 kilogram bout. And the two boxers are coming against each other now. And it's something that is quite interesting. You can see from the way the punches are really coming this time around. And Ahmed Rufai in red corner, Adekunle Adedeji in blue corner. Ahmed Rufai in red corner, trying to absorb punch from Adedeji Adekunle, but Adedeji Adekunle is throwing the punches, and is something that you really have to give it a kind of attention, because it's quite interesting. Like I've been saying, the crowd here are enjoying it. They are really enjoying themselves, and you can't get it anywhere. It's just here at the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame 35th edition of the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame monthly Saturday boxing show. And Ahmed Rufai in red corner, trying to dictate the pace against Adedeji Adekunle in the blue corner. Adedeji Adekunle, a very lanky and tall boxer, and moving closer, trying to bust Ahmed Rufai into a corner. But Ahmed Rufai is trying to hold his own, trying to absorb some kind of punches from Adedeji Adekunle. Innocent, you are still here. What is your take on this bout?
Yeah, Tunji, of course, obviously, this looks like another very interesting bout. The two boxers are trying to size themselves up. So far, so good. Ahmed Rufai have shown some prospects. I expect that Adekunle Adedeji will fight back in no distant time. Of course, the boxers are getting at each other. They are sizing each other up, throwing punches here and there. But let's see. That is a hard one from Ahmed Rufai from the red corner on the face of Rashid defender Adedeji Adekunle in the blue corner. He had one there directly to his face. Hostilities have resumed. Adedeji Adekunle is trying to fight back very strongly from the blue corner. The referee has stopped the contacts, issuing out a warning to Ahmed Rufai in the red corner. Hostilities have resumed now, and the boxers are getting at each other again, throwing punches here and there. They are holding each other now. Let's see what they make out of this. Rufai is like getting the upper hand in this fight. So far, so good. But Adekunle Adedeji, of course, obviously is not relenting. That is the end of the
first round
of this bout and the seventh bout in the Saturday monthly Saturday boxing show here at the Indoor Sports Hall of the Lagos State University Akoka.
Yes, we are resuming back. This is the second round of the seventh bout. And it's 64 kilogram bout between Ahmed Rufai and Adedeji Adekunle. Ahmed Rufai in red corner against Adekunle Adedeji in the blue corner. Ahmed Rufai of no shaking boxing claw against Adedeji Adekunle of diamond boxing claw. And the two boxers are giving it a fight of their life. You can see, even from the red corner, I'm talking about Ahmed Rufai. Ahmed Rufai has been very, very consistent in this one, has been dominant, and is not even ready to take any chance at all, ready to give this boxer, Adedeji Adekunle, a very punch that will land him on the floor, on the ground, and he's moving around, moving everything, moving every strength, every energy into this one, and that is just what we are seeing here. We are seeing here live at the Indoor Sports Hall of the Sports Center, University of Lagos, UNILAG, Akoka, and it's something quite interesting. And you can see Ahmed Rufai has been very, very, very prolific, has been very, very astonishing, has been very, very brilliant. I don't know which other adjective I'm going to use, but the truth of the matter is Ahmed Rufai has been very, very, very consistent in this one, except Adedeji Adekunle is able to come back and respond into this one. But the way he's going, you can see Ahmed Rufai dictating the pace at this point in time. Innocent, what is your take on this one?
Yes, Tunji, obviously, as expected, amateur boxing at its best here at the Indoor Sports Hall of the Sports Center of the University of Lagos, Akoka. Of course, is the bout, the seventh bout between Ahmed Rufai and Adekunle Adedeji. So far, so good. Ahmed Rufai have had the upper hand, raining a barrage of punches on his opponent. But Adekunle is not relenting, trying to fight back, as expected. Where will this fight lead to? The two boxers are holding their own against each other, trying to get the needed point to win this bout. But of course, at the end of the day, Tunji, one boxer, one winner must emerge.
Definitely, Innocent, no doubt about that one. And you can see from the proceedings here, at the moment, Ahmed Rufai is really dictating the pace. But you know, the bell just rang there to signal the end of this round. And yeah, we are resuming again. This is the last round of the seventh bout. It is 64 kilogram bout between Ahmed Rufai and Adedeji Adekunle. Ahmed Rufai in the red corner has been dictating the pace, and it's very evident, it's very obvious. Everybody can see, even an infant can see this one, except Adedeji Adekunle respond quickly. Even in this bout, even a knockout can be a savior in this one. But you can see Ahmed Rufai is not relenting. He's still landing the barrage of punches on Adedeji Adekunle. And Adedeji Adekunle is just taking the referee one in the air. And you can see from what is happening Adedeji Adekunle is just receiving the punches from Ahmed Rufai. Ahmed Rufai has dominated this one, and I must give it to him because he's been so consistent right from the round one, even up to this moment. He has been the star of this one, a star to watch, even though he's not yet a star that everybody knows. But the way he's throwing his punches is something, it's a cause for worry. Crowd here are enjoying themselves because of the way this young man is throwing the punches. He's just throwing the punches, and Adedeji Adekunle is not responding well to the punches. Innocent, again, you are here in this third round that we have witnessed so far at the Indoor Sports Hall of the Sports Center, University of Lagos. What is your make of this? What is your take even of this third round?
Tunji, interesting boxing here. The atmosphere is charged. The spectators here are thrown into ecstasy. Of course, what can you expect from a competition of this nature, of this magnitude? Amateur boxing at its best at the monthly Saturday boxing show. Can Adekunle Adedeji survive this? He's trying to fight back, he's trying to hold his own. But Ahmed Rufai seems, like you said, to be having the upper hand. He has been consistent. How far can he go? Can he do it to the end? Can he hold his own to the end? That is a question that still remains to be answered, Tunji.
It's a nice one, Innocent, no doubt about that. And because Ahmed Rufai has been the dominant force here, he's been dictating the pace, and you can see Adedeji Adekunle is trying to hold him now. It's a signal that the young man is tired, but Ahmed Rufai is leaving no stone unturned. He's just following him without punches everywhere. He's just ready to throw the punch, and that's exactly what is going. A warning there going to Ahmed Rufai, a warning from the referee. But much more importantly, you can see from the best of amateur boxing that we are seeing here is something that is quite interesting, and the crowd here are enjoying themselves. That is the bell that signals the end of the bout. Who is going to take this one? It's a $1 million question. We are awaiting the judge's decision. We are awaiting the judge's decision now. And if the judge's decisions are as good as my guess, I want to give it to one boxer that waits until the decision is finally made. But as it is at the moment, we are awaiting the judge's decision. And in a matter of seconds, minutes, we are going to see the judge's decision. Where will the pendulum swing? Where will the pendulum swing? And oh, this is something quite unimaginable. Quite unimaginable. But that is the judge's decision. We cannot question it. Adedeji Adekunle of Diamond Boxing Club has taken this one. Oh, quite unimaginable. But that is the decision of the judges. But who are we to question it? We just have to let it be.
Good, we are presenting the gift, as usual, to the boxers. That's Ahmed Rufai receiving his gift as the runners-up in this bout. And of course, the winner, Adedeji Adekunle, receiving his trophy and his gift as well. Adedeji Adekunle, the surprise winner of this bout in the monthly Saturday boxing show.
Yes, we are going again, and we are already in the eighth bout, which is between Abua Christian and Said Lawal. Abua Christian in the red corner of Paramount Boxing Club against Said Lawal of WTT Boxing Club in blue corner. This is 69 kilogram bout, and is the eighth bout of this 35th Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame monthly Saturday boxing show, live here inside the Indoor Sports Hall of the Sports Center, University of Lagos, UNILAG, here in Akoka. And Abua Christian in red corner trying to pull down Said Lawal in blue corner. And the two boxers are taking on each other, standing on each other's jungler. And it's something quite interesting. The two boxers, they are the National Sports Festival medal prospect. I must tell you, this bout is something of high interest because the two boxers are medal prospect concerning the 18th National Sports Festival that is going to commence on the 27th of November. And the two boxers are taking on each other, and it's a good ground for them to prepare ahead of this National Sports Festival that is coming up next month. Abua Christian is just moving around the ring, and he's doing it in a very systematic way. He's moving around the ring in a systematic way, and Said Lawal is not ready to just go down and take it like that. Abua Christian is going on a very high way. He's going and he's moving. That punch is something that is much more interesting. Abua Christian of Paramount Boxing Club is just trying to come into this one with much brilliance, much ecstatic, much resilience and firepower that is coming even from what most people don't even expect. But that is the makeup of boxing, amateur boxing, best of amateur boxing here live at the Indoor Sports Hall of the Sports Center in University of Lagos here in Akoka. It's quite interesting. I must tell you the crowd are enjoying this one. They're enjoying it. It's quite interesting, it's quite entertaining, and it's something that they can't even go anywhere, use money to watch, but they are enjoying it here free of charge at the Indoor Sports Hall, live at the Indoor Sports Hall at the University of Lagos. What can you say to this, Innocent?
Yes, I'm Tunji. Abua Christian is another young boxer.
Yes, we are coming into the second round of this bout. Innocent, what is your take on this one?
Yeah, Tunji, of course, the bout between Abua Christian and Said Lawal. Abua Christian is another young boxer that have been consistent after he was discovered from the Adopt a Talent program held by Lagos State, the grassroots program organized by Lagos State. Since then, he has been consistent. He has been showing a lot of prospects. A lot of people have predicted that he can also win medals at the National Sports Festival for Lagos. How true this will be, only time will tell. But of course, it's been a good bout. So far, so good. Abua Christian have held his own. Of course, Said Lawal is not a pushover as well as far as amateur boxing is concerned. He too has been consistent so far. But where this one will end, only time will tell. The referee have just stopped the bout. The hostilities have commenced again. Abua Christian is jabbing his opponent at the moment. They are sizing themselves up, trying to get the better of themselves. But I don't know. It's like so far so good. We've not seen much of these two boxers. It's like they are both conscious of themselves at the moment. But Said Lawal is trying to throw some punches now. He's trying to get the points and, of course, go ahead to win this fight. But, of course, it is still the second round in this bout. What this bout holds for us, only time will tell, Tunji.
It's quite interesting. I can see it's a very tight one because the two boxers know each other very well. It's a kind of knowing each other, a familiar foe. We normally say that. And it's something that is quite interesting because Abua Christian is not new to Said Lawal, and Said Lawal is not also new to Abua Christian. So it's quite interesting. The two of them are really sizing it. They are sizing up themselves and they are throwing punches at each other. It's quite interesting. You can see Abua Christian and moving, taking it from another level and trying to do it systematically against Said Lawal. Said Lawal is jogging and trying to take it very close to Abua Christian. Abua Christian is taking his time, trying to throw the punches in a very, very you know, magnetic way, and is something that is quite interesting, quite rewarding, quite entertaining, and is something that is much more important, is quite interesting here. Abua Christian and Said Lawa are doing it in a very, very good way, in a very systematic way, in a very nice way, in a very good way, in a very, you know, you can go on and on. I can go on and on and give you all of these. The bell just rang there to signal the end of this round. Where will the pendulum swing? Said Lawa, Abua Christian. We await the judge's decision. Go again. This is the last round of this bout, and Said Lawa is coming powerfully into this one, just resuming into this one with heavy punches against Abua Christian. But Abua Christian is trying to come back in a very systematic way, like his usual style, right from the first round of this bout. And it's something quite interesting, I must tell you. Abua Christian is picking his point in a systematic way. He's not even jumping around. He's just throwing the punches and picking his point. So that is what boxing is all about. It's just about getting your target right. And that's exactly what we are seeing here. Said Lawa is receiving warning from the referee now, and it's something that we can't even imagine here, because the two boxers know each other very well. From the way they box, from where they come to each other, you will know that they know each other very well. It's like they are best of sparring partners, and I wouldn't know, but from the way they throw their punches, it shows that they really know each other very well. And the referee just stopped fight again, giving Said Lawa warning, proceedings resume again. And Abua Christian is trying to do it systematic, the way he's been doing it, and dodging punches from Said Lawa. It's quite interesting, quite entertaining, quite astonishing, I must tell you. And it's something that a lot of people will have to come and enjoy, because the crowd here is not even, you know, enough at this point in time, even though they are enjoying it, because but by the way this boxing show is going, is gathering momentum. People are getting to know about it day in, day out. Every month more crowd are getting to know about it, and right here at the indoor sports hall of the Sports Center, University of Lagos, the boxers are doing it again, preparing themselves for the forthcoming National Sports Festival that will be hosted here in Lagos. So, Innocent, what is your take about these boxers? They are, according to the way we look at it, they are supposed to be medal prospects for Lagos. So what is your take on the two of them?
Yeah, so far so good. They have shown class, they have shown resilience, they have shown determination to win this bout. I wouldn't be surprised if Said Lawa eventually emerge winner in this bout, because of the way he's coming forward and unleashing serious punches on Christian Abua. A lot of people have criticized Christian Abua as being known for being